Hello everyone, a very 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 happy new year to all of you. I'm so excited to enter 2021 after a 2020 that was actually quite unexpected. So I thought of starting the new year with a productivity video, but I feel like a lot of productivity videos are going to come up now, so I thought of starting with something a little different. So I'm going to share with you two dessert recipes, because why not start the year on a sweet note? So I'm sharing two of my favorite healthy dessert recipes with the hope that you will make them and you will start your 2021 with a sweet note. With that, let's begin. I hope you enjoy this. So the very first recipe that I'm going to talk about today is the healthiest, yummiest and the easiest kulfi that you can make at home. All you need is milk, milk powder and some jaggery. That's it, just three ingredients and you'll have your kulfi ready. So we'll take a pan to which we're going to add about half a liter of milk. You can add more if you want to make more quantity, but half liter is good enough. And then let this come to a boil. Once it starts boiling a little bit, you can go ahead and add about 4 tablespoons of milk powder to this and stir the whole thing up. Make sure that you stir it well so that there are no lumps in it. And then we're going to go ahead and add jaggery. Now we're adding about 2 to 3 tablespoons of jaggery, but you can add a little more or less depending on your likeness for sweetness. And then stir the whole thing and let this whole thing come to a boil. It'll change the color a little bit, it'll become a little brownish because of the jaggery, and you will see that it starts looking like how it is looking on the screen right now. And then after a bit you can turn off the gas and then you can transfer it to a bowl. You can let this be out for about half an hour, 15 to 20 minutes, and then you can cover it up and we're going to go ahead and put this in the freezer. You will need to let it be in the freezer for about half a day, and then the kulfi will be completely ready. Once you take it out from the freezer, you will just have to let it be outside for about 2 to 3 minutes so that it loosens up a little bit, and then the kulfi will be completely ready to eat. So we're going to take it off into a bowl. And for garnishing, you can add any and everything you like. For now, we are adding some dried fruits, so some cashews and a little bit of badam. And then you can always choose to add some rose petals as well. And yeah, the kulfi is completely ready to have. I am sure you will love this. Please try and make this at home. It's one of the most delicious things you can have. The next thing we're going to make is this paan dessert. So if you are a paan lover, you will actually quite like this particular dessert. For this you need sauf or fennel, some gulkand, some dried fruits, coconut and paan leaves. So in a blender we're going to go ahead and drop in all of these ingredients. So we're starting with the sauf powder or fennel powder. You can add whole fennel also. Then we're going to go ahead and add dried coconut, and then we'll tear in the paan leaves and we'll add that too. Now we'll go ahead and quickly blend this whole thing together till it comes to a paste-like consistency. So this is how it's going to look after you've ground it up. And then we'll go ahead and add the gulkand. If you don't find gulkand, you can add rose jam as well, but a gulkand will just add a completely different flavor. And then we're going to add some soaked dried fruits. So cashews and badam is what we're adding, but you can add whatever you like. And then we'll drop a little bit of water into it and then we'll blend the whole thing together. This paste that we are blending right now, you can easily store this in the fridge also, and you can make this dessert multiple times. So the paste that we're making right now will be used, a part of it will be used to make a few servings of this, and then rest you can store it in the freezer. So this is how it'll look after blending. So now we're going to take a little bit of this and we're going to add some sugar to this and some milk into a blending jar, and then we're going to blend this whole thing together and your paan drink will be completely ready. You just need to add about 1 tablespoon to 1.5 tablespoon of paan mix that we just made into 1 glass of paan drink, and yeah, you just need to pour it into glasses and you can enjoy it. If you are a paan lover, you're going to love this. Just you can garnish it with whatever you like rose petals or any dried fruits, and yeah, this is one of our favorites at our home because we all like paan. So if you do like paan, make sure that you give this a shot. And yeah, with that, I am taking your leave today. I hope you have a great 2021 and do try these recipes out. And if you do, let me know how you like them on Instagram or in the comments below. I'll see you. Bye.